notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see ESET important topics. What are the best books for ESET? Marks versus rank. What are last minute preparation tips for ESET? What are cheat codes for ESET? How to qualify ESET in one day? Exam day rules and tricks, and what all you need to carry to your exam center, okay, on the exam day. All these things we are going to see in this video, so make sure you watch this video till the end. So now let's see what are important topics subject wise and what are the standard and best books for ESET. Okay, so first coming to physics, the most important topics are, first most important topic is unit and dimension. Very important, unit and dimension. Next is elements of vectors. Elements of vectors. Okay, so next is kinematics and friction. Very, very important topic, this kinematics and friction is. And next is work, power and energy. Okay, last but not least, heat and thermodynamics. Okay, so all these five topics which I gave you is at most important topics coming to physics. Okay, unit and dimension, elements of vectors, kinematics and friction, work, power and energy, heat and thermodynamics, the most important chapters. Now let's see what are the best books for physics. Okay, first best book is Concepts of Physics by H.C. Verma. Okay, Concepts of Physics by H.C. Verma. Next is Understanding Physics by D.C. Pandey. So now let's see what are the at most important topics coming to chemistry. Okay, so coming to chemistry, first most important topic is atomic structure. At most important topic, at most important chapter. Okay, so next is chemical bonding. Electrochemistry. Okay. So next is Environmental Chemistry. Last but not least, corrosion polymers and fuels. Okay, so these are at most important topics coming to chemistry. Okay, so now let's see what are the best books for chemistry. First best book is Organic Chemistry by Tandon. 12th Chemistry by Ensert. Okay, so these are the standard books coming to chemistry. See what are the most important topics coming to mathematics. Okay, so first most important topic is matrices. Standard topic. Matrices, probability, differentiation, trigonometry, integration, sets, complex numbers, and analytical geometry. Okay, so these topics are really important. And now let's see what are the standard books coming to mathematics. First standard book is Mathematics by R.S. Agarwal. Next is Encert, okay, 11th and 12th class mathematics. Encert is really important. And next is Mathematics by R.D. Sharma. So these are very important topics coming to mathematics. Now let's see for communicative English. First is you need to concentrate on grammar. Okay, so whatever question comes, mostly if you know grammar, you can get 90% of the solution. Okay, because every question is completely dependent on grammar. So make sure you're good at grammar. And next is concentrate on prepositions. Prepositions are also very important. Next is tenses, antonyms and synonyms. Antonyms and synonyms are very important. Spotting errors. One word substitution. Okay. Idioms. Sentence correction or sentence improvement. Okay. And last but not least, reading comprehension. Okay, so I'm going to give you tips for reading comprehension. Okay, see, most of the students will lose time only with reading comprehension, and after solving reading comprehension they have no time left for other questions. This type of problem students will be facing. See students, coming to reading comprehension, what normally students does is they'll read the passage and then they'll read the questions. Don't do that. First read questions. First, read questions and then start searching solutions for those questions from comprehension, from the given passage. Okay, just try this tip. It's going to work and you're going to save a lot of time, trust me. Okay, so now let's see what are the best books coming to English. First is Communicative English by Dr. Ruchi, and second is Communicative English by Dr. Anuradha. Now let's see what are the standard topics from reasoning. Okay, coming to reasoning, concentrate on coding, decoding, then concentrate on data sufficiency is nothing but table, graph, pie chart, Venn diagram. So all these type of questions will be asked. Okay, and next is concentrate on arrangement problems. Okay, clock and calendar problems, very important. Clock and calendar problems. last but not least, blood relations. Okay, so guys, I have a bonus tip even for blood relations. Coming to blood relations, start reading the question from last to first. You are really, really going to get the answer within less than 20 to 30 seconds. Now let's see what are the standard books coming to reasoning. Okay, so first is Reasoning by R.S. Agarwal. It's really, really useful and standard book. Next is Nonverbal Reasoning by S. Chand, one of the other standard book. Okay, see ESET marks versus rank. Most of the students will be having doubts like, if I get these many marks, how much rank will I get? All these doubts I'm going to clear in this particular video. So if your marks are in between 150 to 160 or above 160, your rank is going to be between 1 to 10. Okay. If your marks are in between 140 to 150, your rank will be in between 10 to 20. Okay. So if your marks are in between 130 to 139, your rank will be in between 21 to 30. If your marks are in between 120 to 130, your rank is going to be in between 31 to 40. And if your marks are in between 110 to 119, your rank is going to be 40 to 50. In between 40 to 50. Like this, you can calculate your rank based on your marks. Okay. Okay. So now let's see how to qualify exam in one day. Okay. First, let's see how to qualify exam in one day. Okay. And now I'm explaining how to qualify exam in one day. Okay. For the students who have not studied anything, who have not started their revision preparation, nothing, for those students this video is. Okay, so after explaining how to qualify exam in one day, I am going to explain last minute preparation tips to get a good score in ESET. Okay, there will be four different sections: maths, physics, chemistry and your core. Okay, so there will be questions from four different sections. Max marks will be 50, physics 25, chemistry 25, and 100 marks will be from core. Okay, and we all know the qualifying marks is just 25%. Okay, just qualifying mark is 25%. So the total paper is going to be for 200 marks. We all know that, right? See, out of 200 marks, 25% is 50 marks. So you need to get 50 marks in order to qualify. So now let's see how can you qualify in just one day. Okay, now our target is to qualify in just one day. So now let's see how. Okay, coming to mathematics, I have already given you the important questions. If you have not seen that video, the link is in the description below. I have given important topics for mathematics, physics as well as chemistry. You need to go through those videos, and if you just prepared those topics, trust me, you're going to get a great score in each of those subjects. Okay, so now let's come back to the video. Coming to mathematics, if you follow the important topics which I gave, worst case, you are surely going to get 20 marks. Okay, worst case. If you just read half of the topics which I gave you, you are still going to get 20 marks. Okay, why I am assuring you to take 20 marks as the least case is, first thing is, there is no negative marking. We all know there is no negative marking in the ESET. So out of 50 questions, if you attempt all the 50 questions also, you're still not going to have any negative marking. So you can attempt 50 questions out of 50 questions. In those 50, I'm sure you're going to get at least 20 marks in the worst case. Okay, so now coming to physics, let's consider you get only 10. Let's consider minimum 10 marks you're going to get. And coming to chemistry, let's think you got only 10 marks. Okay, so here 20 plus 10 plus 10, already you got 40. And the qualifying marks is just 50. So, in core subject, out of 100, minimum you're going to get 30 marks. Minimum, okay? Because core is something which you have already read. So, in core, minimum 30 marks you're going to get. And if you don't know any question, don't leave it. Attempt all the questions because there is no negative marking coming to ESET exam. Remember this technique which I told you, and you can easily qualify ESET exam using. Let's see what are last minute preparation tips. Last minute preparation tips for ESET. Okay. First thing is just analyze how many days are left for exam. For example, if you are left with only 2 days for exam, completely you need to schedule that 2 days. Okay. So that 2 days, prepare a timetable and make sure 60 to 70% of the timetable should consist of your weak subjects and weak topics. Weak topics and weak subjects. Okay. In subjects which you are not confident in the topics which you don't know properly, concentrate on those topics. Okay, this is first preparation tip. Okay, next is you need to prepare short notes. What is short notes? Maintain a small book while reading physics or while reading mathematics or chemistry or in fact any subject. Coming to chemistry, if you read any important equation, or coming to mathematics, if you read any important formula, immediately you need to note that formula in the short notes. Okay, so why I am asking you to maintain a separate short notes is just before the exam, also you can just open that book and go through a quick revision. So, coming to mathematics, we already know. Formula is very, very important. Only when you remember the formula, only you're going to solve the problem. So, maintain a short notebook and revise it thoroughly every day. Okay. So, whenever you're going to take a small breaks in between your study sessions, just go through those short notes and have a quick revision. Okay. Attempt mock tests. Okay. There will be many mock tests. Just attempt them. And after why I am asking you to attempt mock tests is once you give mock tests, you'll understand what kind of questions are coming, how you are solving the paper, and in which subject you're getting stuck, in which question you're getting stuck, and how is your time management. All these things you can understand only after giving mock tests. Okay, so first give mock tests, and after giving mock tests, make sure you analyze your mistakes and don't repeat those mistakes in final exam. Okay, so next is solve the previous papers. Previous year's papers are really important. You'll understand what is the difficulty level of the questions which are appearing in the exam and what kind of questions are asked in the exam. All these things you can understand only by looking previous papers. Okay, so and next important tip is don't start new topics. Don't start new topics. See guys, you already know if you are left only with few days of your exam, don't start any new topic. If you start any new topic, you'll be confused what you read already. Those topics also you're going to forget. So that's why don't start any new topic. And next is concentrate on high weightage topics, high weightage and important topics. Whatever topics I gave you as important or a high weightage, concentrate on those topics, okay, in order to get a very good score in your exams. Next important thing is time management. Manage your time wisely. Time management is really important because you have a limited time and so many questions. So don't waste your time. Before going to exam only, fix your mind how much time you're going to give for single question. After that time, just automatically go for next question. Don't waste your time just by getting stuck with single question. Okay. Next important thing is before your exam on exam day only, make sure you put all your required things at a place so that on exam day there you need not panic searching for the documents, admit card and all. So now let's see what is easy cheat codes. The first important cheat code is avoid extreme values. What is this? What is meant by avoid extreme values? See, for example, there is a question and there are four options. Option A is 4, option B is 3, option C is 6, option D is 22. Okay, so see, these are all single digit values and these are near. Option D is completely different. It's a double digit value and it is an extreme. So when you are trying to guess the answer, don't go for extreme values. Correct answer is going to be out one out of these three, but not 22. Always avoid extreme values while you are guessing the answer. Okay. The important thing is use elimination method. What is elimination method? Coming to the elimination method, when there is a question and when there are four options, try to, and you don't know what is the correct answer, then try to eliminate irrelevant two options. Okay, using the concept which you know related to that question, use your concept and use your common sense and make sure you eliminate at least two of the options, and out of the rest over options, one you can just put as your answer if you don't know the correct answer. Okay, so like this, you need to use the elimination method and you need to eliminate irrelevant options so that it will be easy for you to guess the correct answer. Okay, next important tip is all of the above and none of the above tip. Okay, so what is all of the above, none of the above tip? If you don't know the correct answer and if you see one of the option as all of the above, go for it. There will be high chances of all of the above being the correct answer. But if you see none of the above is correct, one of the option, don't go for it. Okay. All of the above has high probability to be the correct answer. None of the above has very low probability of being the correct answer. So now let's see what are exam day tricks for ESET. Okay, so first is you need to carry all your necessary documents, that is admit card and ID proof. Coming to ID proof, there are few valid ID proofs, that is you can carry your Aadhaar card, you can carry your voter ID, driving license. These comes under valid ID proofs and only valid ID proofs are allowed to exam. Okay, so first you need to carry your necessary documents and make sure you pack your necessary documents the day before exam only, so that you at the last moment you can relaxedly go for exam instead of searching your admit card or ID proofs. Okay, so next is at least reach 1 hour before exam. Okay, so coming to this year especially, there will be so many protocols which you need to undergo. There will be thermal screening. That's why it's better if you reach at least 1 hour before exam, so relaxedly you can fulfill all those protocols, you can fulfill all those things and go to your exam. Okay, next is read all the instructions of the question paper. Okay, so what are instructions they gave in the question paper front end, read them carefully. Okay, see, this is a small thing, but students' intention will not do that, but you must read all the instructions which is given on the question paper. And next is read question paper first. Okay, first read the question paper before starting the exam. Okay, so once you read the question paper, you'll understand if the paper is lengthy, if the paper is tough or easy or moderate, all these things you can understand. Based on that, you can schedule your time. Okay, you can break down your time into slots for each and every subject. That's why read the question paper completely first. Okay, so last but not least, attempt easy questions first. First, attempt all the easy questions. Easy questions will surely take very less time after attempting all the easy questions and all the questions which you know. Then go for difficult questions and relaxedly you can attempt all the difficult questions also. Okay, so now let's see what are the best colleges for ESET. Aurora Research and Technology. This is a very good college. And next is GMR, the Institute of Technology, Rajiv Gandhi Memorial College of Engineering and Technology, Annam Acharya Institute of Technology and Sciences. These are the best and top colleges for ESET. So yeah guys, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. All the very best for the students. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends, and thanks for watching.